Hello guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to control textures with an object in Geometry Nodes. Using textures in Geometry Nodes is really useful. You can use them to randomize some stuff like the position of vertices, but sometimes we want to control the texture for some animation or to change something we don't like. In the shader nodes, if you want to control a texture with other object, you only need to add a texture coordinate node, connect the object to vector and select the object you want to use to control the texture. But in Geometry Nodes, we now have a texture coordinate node, so we have no choice but to do it with vector map nodes and our own dirty hands. First, I will show you the node tree, then I will explain how everything works. I will show you a simple example so we can concentrate only in the vector math. Using a simple plane with a lot of subdivisions, adding a set position node, a combined x-y-axis node in the offset input and connecting the texture in the z-input, that way the texture only changes the vertical position of the vertices. Now, the first question is, what value we have to modify to control the texture? Well, the simple fact that the texture is working means that it's already using a vector value, and we can see this value by simply positioning the mouse on top of the vector input. Here, we can see it's using the position value. So, we connect the position node, and because it's already using this value, nothing changed, but now we can modify it. Now, we add the information of the object we want to use to control the texture. The first thing we want to control is the position, so the most logical solution is to use the addition operation of the vector map node, but the result is reversed. Why is this happening? Well, first let me explain really quick how vector operations work. Vectors in Blender are nothing more than three values in a list. In the case of position, three C values are x, y, and z. So, when we make some simple operation like addition, we are only adding the x values to the other x values, the y values to the other y values, and the z values to the other z values. So, in Geometry Nodes, what we are doing is adding the position values of each vertex with the position value of the control object. In Blender, you can check this because when we are using multiple values, it shows this dotted line, and when we are using only one value, it shows a solid line. Now, if we show the x values of each vertex as colors in the viewport while we make the addition operation, we can see why the results we want is reversed. For example, if we move the control object 0.5 units in the x-axis, transform the 0 to 0.5. The 0.5 to 1, and the 1 to 1.5. So, we can solve this by changing the addition operation to subtraction. This works because in math, subtraction is the opposite operation of addition. And if you're wondering what this Boolean node does, I use it to change the operation from addition to subtraction in the numbers visualization. Now, we need to control the texture rotation. For that, we use the vector rotate node with type rotation Euler. We connect the rotation to rotation and we can see that the result is reversed. And just like the position, I would love to explain why, but I myself don't understand why this is happening. The only thing that I'm sure is that rotation in math is really complicated. And well, to solve this, you only need to activate the option invert in the vector rotate node. Now we only need to control the scale of the texture. For that, we can use the multiplication operation. But the result once again is reversed. Here the explanation is the same as the control of the position. When we multiply the x values of the vertices by the scale of the control object, we can see what is happening. Just like the addition, we need the opposite operation of multiplication, and that will be the division operation. And that's all! Now you know how to control a texture with an object in Geometry Nodes. And before finishing this video, I want to show you an example of how to use this object in a real-life scenario. The best advantage of this method is that you can easily observe the changes you do to the texture. So, when you do something really complex like this example of my background animation, you understand exactly what you are doing. In this case, I parented the control object to an empty, so when I rotate the parent, the control rotates around it, making a seamless loop animation in a really simple way. Well, this is the end of the video. If the information was useful for you, hit the like button and subscribe. Take care and see you later.